term for desmoplastic trichoepithelioma is sclerosing epithelial hamartoma. These lesions are benign skin adnexal tumours derived from hair follicles. They are solitary lesions. They almost always occur on the face. The size varies from 3 to 8 millimetres. They present as indurated lesions, occurring more frequently in females than males, and tend to present in early childhood to the second decade. Histologically, desmoplastic trichoepitheliomas are composed of narrow strands of basaloid cells 1 to 3 cells thick, and these cells line a desmoplastic stroma. And here is the problem. Because the cells are basaloid and because the stroma is desmoplastic, they can be misdiagnosed as sclerosing basal cell carcinomas. That is the main differential diagnosis. However, desmoplastic trichoepitheliomas contain horn cysts, whereas sclerosing basal cell carcinomas don't. This is a very low power view of a desmoplastic trichoepithelioma. At the top right of the picture is a purple area. This is a calcified horn cyst. On higher magnification, the strands of basaloid cells become apparent. And towards the left of the picture you can see horn cysts. And on even higher magnification, the rather bland nature of the basaloid cells forming strands can be appreciated. The stroma is clearly desmoplastic, composed of dense fibrous tissue. In summary, histologically, desmoplastic trichoepitheliomas are composed of strands of rather bland basaloid cells, 1 to 3 layers thick, with the presence of horn cysts, some of which may calcify, and the stroma is desmoplastic.